Hello everyone, and welcome back to Foster the Meeple, a channel all about board games and board gamey things. I'm Jamie.
I'm Jeff.
And today we have an overview and review of the game Dwarves Winter from Vesuvius Media and designed by Louis Brouet.
Indeed.
And Vesuvius Media just happens to be a local game publisher to our city in Halifax, so we're really excited to be doing this.
Yeah.
So Vesuvius Media was kind enough to gift us with these two games, so Dwarves Winter as well as the Legendary expansion, as well as Dwarves Fall, mm-hmm. which is the prequel to Dwarves Winter.
Yes, indeed.
But today we're here to talk about Dwarves Winter because there is another expansion coming to Kickstarter very soon.
Yeah, we're excited.
We are excited.
This was the first time we played Dwarves Winter, mm-hmm. and we had a fabulous time.
It was a fabulous time.
I did not win.
You did not win.
I did not win.
That sucks for you.
Yeah, it does suck for me.
It's pretty great for me.
Yeah.
We're going to go through just an overview of the game. We're going to talk about a few different parts mm-hmm. of the game, things that we like, maybe a little bit of critique.
Yep.
So we're going to start off, like I said, with an overview of the game. Jeff, would you like to give an overview of the game?
Dwarves Winter is a cooperative tower defense hand-building game for 1 to 4 players. Players strive to earn the most victory points by defending the kingdom against monsters and repairing damage caused by disasters. But the only way to survive the 7 weeks of winter is to work together. Winter is here. Battle through the harsh elements and defend your kingdom against chillingly scary monsters.
Dun, dun, dun. It's basically like Canada the board game.
It is still freezing in Canada. It was good timing.
Good timing.
Winter grips the land in its icy clutches. The dwarves will need to battle both terrifying creatures and the deadly elements if they are to survive. But while each clan wants to earn the most victory points, the only way to survive the harsh winter is for them to work together. A game of Dwarves Winter lasts 7 rounds, called weeks. Each week is divided into 4 phases. After the end of the 7th week, final scoring takes place and a winner is determined. I guess we'll jump into the theming of the game, perhaps?
Let's talk about the theme. And what we think. So basically, obviously, this theme, it's... What did you call it? A castle or...
It is a tower defense game.
Tower defense game.
Semi-co-op tower defense, I guess, would be the best way.
Yes. So that is an important thing about this game. It's a semi-co-op piece. But the theme is all about dwarves in the winter.
So you are a clan, I guess, of dwarves. Each player would act as their own kind of clan, and you're defending your tower from oncoming monsters that will spawn in certain areas, and they will trek their way towards your tower. You take actions in order to defend, destroy, kill those monsters so that they don't get to the tower. And on top of that, there are...
Crises or disasters.
Disasters that will happen that you also have to clear off the map. So it's mm-hmm. kind of this two-angled tower defense game where there's multiple things that can happen. And again, if you have any monsters on the tower or too much disaster on the map, you lose.
You lose.
And it is semi-co-op because you're cooperatively trying to ensure that the monsters are killed and disasters are cleared. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the game, there is a winner. So you will score individual points based on how many monsters you kill, disasters you clear, resources you collect, and that sort of thing. So mm-hmm. cooperatively, but also...
Not so cooperatively,
because Jamie won and I did not.
Yes, which is a really, really interesting part of this game, which we can get into in a minute. Mm-hmm. But overall, the theme, I really like it. I love the dwarves, and it's probably because Snow White mm-hmm. is a character in this game. So, like, think about the dwarves, and I think that's the reason why it has 7 in it, because think of Snow White and the 7 dwarves.
Yeah.
So that theme has me sold. The artwork has me sold.
Theme-wise, super into it as well. Yeah, this is honestly maybe my first or second tower defense game. We haven't played a ton of them. This is actually a great one. I mean, if you're wanting to play a tower defense mm-hmm. game and you've never played one before, this would be a great place to start. It's very simple. I don't know how complicated tower defense board games get, but this one was very easy to learn and play mm-hmm. incredibly quickly for us.
Yes, Now, let's jump into the components. Mm-hmm. So this game comes with a lot of components, mainly minifigures.
Yeah, really nice minifigs.
Yes. So it comes with four sets of dwarves. Mm-hmm. So there's four different colors. You can play this with up to four players. And it comes with two of each of the monster types. So the minifigures are really well made. I think they would look amazing painted.
Yeah, they're big enough that you could paint them if you wanted to. The minifigs in this game are top-notch. The cards are great. So the tokens in this game are also really well made. A high production value. Mm-hmm. 9 out of 10 for the components in this game, honestly.
Yes. And the cards are made out of this like really cool material that I feel like you could like, this is going to sound weird, I was going to say take them in the back with you and they wouldn't get destroyed.
Yeah, I don't know what the material's called.
It's plasticky.
I felt it on like certain types of like hockey cards, like the holographic hockey cards are kind of plasticky, but I don't think you'd ever be in a situation where these would get ripped or destroyed like if you spilled something on them. They're high quality production in terms of everything, honestly.
Mm-hmm. And I've already mentioned this, but the artwork on everything, including the game board, is amazing. Like, I love the artwork. It reminds me of something, and I can't remember exactly what it reminds me of. What did I say before?
It reminds me a little bit of like,
Adventure Time.
Yeah, Adventure Time, and if you've ever played Clash of Clans.
Oh, yeah. So, moving into the rules of this game, and basically what we want to talk about is how easy were the rules to understand. Mm-hmm. Do we have to keep referencing back to the rules? Like, just that kind of how well put together was the rule book, I guess, essentially.
Yeah. I mean, I thought it was really well put together. Given that this was one of our first tower defense games, there was a little bit of a learning curve. Just to understand exactly how the monsters moved. It's actually super simple in this game. Once they spawn, the first player gets to move them. Mm-hmm. So as long as they're moving towards the tower, all of those movements are valid. Mm-hmm. It's just the initial kind of like, are we sure we're doing this right? We are referencing the rule book to make sure. But other than that, very, very straightforward.
Mm-hmm. It's laid out really, really well. It literally goes through every phase and then it gives you examples of every phase, mm-hmm. which I found to be super helpful.
Yep.
Like with little pictures, like if this were to happen, then this would happen. So I found that was really helpful.
Yeah, the only critique I would have of this game is actually in regards to the rule book.
Not necessarily the rule
book. Not the rule book.
It's the lack of reference.
Yeah, so when you have your cards in this game, they all have symbols mm-hmm. of what the action is to do.
Yeah.
And there's enough of them that you're, especially on your first playthrough, you're not going to remember what they all are. Mm-hmm. So we were constantly referring back to the rule book to determine what the cards were. And we had said during that time, we wish we had a small little reference card for each player in front of us so that we didn't have to reference the rule book every time.
Yes.
That's really the only critique I have of this game. Not a lot of games do that well. So
no, they do not.
That's also a personal preference of ours. We just like games that have that reference card. Mm-hmm. So that would be the only critique I would have. And it's not really related to the rule book.
No.
But somewhat, so it's probably worth mentioning here.
Yeah, and I think it's mainly because it's not only like the heroes all have abilities, but then there's also things you need to look at for like the monster cards or the disaster mm-hmm. cards. So you're kind of like flipping back and forth in between the rule book. So it's like if we could just keep one page open, that would be great. But we kind of had to do a flippy floppy.
That's the only thing that we kind of thought of while we were playing. That this would just be a little bit better if we had a reference card.
Yes.
But I mean, really.
That's pretty nitpicky.
Yeah, we're picking nits.
We're picking nits.
For sure.
So next up, we just have gameplay and replayability. For gameplay, like I said, once you do a full playthrough, so full transparency, like we set up the game once, and then we were like, wow, this looks impossible. And then we realized that, like, kind of some of the synergies and, like, the strategy of the game. Mm-hmm. So we're like, let's just start over. And when we did that restart and understanding the strategy of the game, it was much, much easier to play. So I think if that happens to you, don't get discouraged mm-hmm. because every round, the monsters are moving closer to the castle, more disasters are happening, mm-hmm. and you're like, I'm overwhelmed.
Yeah, we felt overwhelmed very quickly in our first playthrough.
Yeah.
So we played it and we got a couple weeks in. Mm-hmm. We were like, man, this is really hard. Like, we're getting incredibly overwhelmed here. There's no way we're going to beat this. So we just said, okay, we probably didn't do
something right.
Something right from the start. Let's reset and try this again. But like Jamie said, the second time after we reset, we were smooth sailing.
Yeah. And in terms of replayability, I think it would be relatively good, but the benefit is that there are expansions available that add new monsters and new different classes of the dwarves. So in the base game, all the dwarves are the same.
Yep.
In the legendary expansion, you get a few different dwarves that are different classes, so they have different abilities. So I think in terms of replayability, it's pretty good, specifically because there are expansions that help you with that.
Replayability, I play it again.
Yeah, for sure.
I think, again, it's, we don't play a ton of tower defense, so this would be something we would likely keep playing so that we get more comfortable with that realm of board game. We had a lot of fun playing it, and I think we played it in like 30 minutes to 45
minutes.
At two player. We should mention we played it at two player.
Yeah.
I do think it would be interesting to play it at a higher player count.
Well, because it adds more monsters.
Yeah, so it scales per player. Replayability is pretty high for me on this one. Yeah,
for sure. Me too. And final thoughts.
Final thoughts. Really liked it. I'm really looking forward to the upcoming Kickstarter. Again, I really am a big fan of what Vesuvius Media does. It is also awesome that they're in our local city here.
I'm really wanting to play Dwarf Spring. So I would like to mention, like, this is a series. We've already mentioned Dwarf's Fall, Dwarf's Winter, Dwarf Spring. Those three games are all currently out, and Dwarf Summer will be coming soon. And the beauty of all of these games is that they are tied together in theme, but each of them is its own unique standalone game that plays differently. So as an example, Dwarf's Fall is kind of like a tile placement game. This one is a semi co-op tower defense hand management resource gathering game. Dwarf Spring is a worker placement engine building game. And I'm not sure what Dwarf Summer is going to be, but I'm sure it's also going to be different. So I just think that's really cool because you can kind of get into the whole series. You can kind of really immerse yourself in the theme, but have a lot of variation in the gameplay between the different
mechanically games. I do definitely want to play Spring. We don't have Spring, unfortunately, but it might be something we pick up soon. Really looking forward to that upcoming Kickstarter.
And I don't think we've played any semi-co-op games in this way, so that was also really interesting.
I think we've played some semi-co-op. We're super competitive, by the way. So what happened in this game
I know what you're gonna say.
Was I would be like, there'd be a monster in Jamie's area, and I'd be like, hey, I can get that monster. Don't worry about it. You go do something else. And she's like, why?
Yeah, or there was specifically, you're like, can you get that dragon? And I looked, because each monster has a different value, like a different victory points. So I was like, heck yeah, I'll get that monster, because it has the highest victory points for the dragon.
Yeah, so there's a little bit of like intrigue. We need to kill the monsters, because if we don't, we both lose.
Yeah.
But if I kill it, or you kill it, you're going to get the victory points associated to that monster. So there's a little bit of that kind of give and take, which was really fun.
Added element of strategy.
We had a lot of fun with it. I highly, highly, highly recommend trying out Dwarves Winter.
That is our overview and review of Dwarves Winter. Keep your eyes peeled for the Kickstarter that is coming soon. When it's live, we will add links below. We'll also add links to Vesuvius Media's website if you'd like to check out some of their other games. But let us know down below if you've had an opportunity to play any of the Dwarves games. We would love to know what you think. And we thank you so much for watching. If you like what you see, please subscribe to Foster the Meeple, and don't forget to follow us on social media. On Instagram, we are at Foster the Meeple. So with that, we say goodbye.
Later days.
Goodbye. No, honey. Come on. You're too loud.
You just tell
me. Just a second.
Okay.
There's hair in my mouth.
I just spit like across the table.
Gross. Yeah, so you're gonna know what we talk about.
That's awkward.
So awkward, I didn't even know where to go from there.
Yeah.
Okay, so just need to regroup. Here's a critique. I can't get the box open.
That's not the, that's user error. Enemy in.
Enemy invasion.
Phase one, enemy invasion. Bunch of cuts and stuff.
That was long hair.
Yeah, so...
Yeah. And I do enjoy a good monster killing spree. No.